Okay, good morning, students. Yesterday, up to 13th sum, we finished step using step division method. That is top left column, class intervals are given. Now we are going to do the 14th sum. Here they give, this is somewhat different method. For a group of 100 students, so number of students is, it is given as 100. So this is 100. The mean and standard deviation. Mean standard deviation of their marks were 60 and 50 respectively. So mean is 60, standard deviation is 50. Later on it was found that the scores 45 and 72. So two numbers they are giving, 45 and 72 were wrongly entered as 40 27. So instead of 45 they enter as 40, instead of 72 they enter as 27. Find the correct mean and standard deviation. So here they are giving so much of information, number of students 100, mean standard deviation, wrong values, two wrong values are given and two correct values are given. We have to find the correct mean and standard deviation. So now we can do the sum. So first we write given. So given number of candidates, number of candidates comma, we take it as small n is equal to 100. Next mean, first we give write what are given in the question. Mean is equal to mean, we use the symbol x bar, so comma, x bar is equal to 60. Standard deviation sigma, the symbol for standard deviation sigma is equal to 50, comma, sigma is equal to 50. Next one, wrong values, two wrong values are given, two correct values are given. So correct values is equal to 45 and 72. Instead of giving two values, in creatism they will give one value or three values like that. So procedure doing sum is the same procedure. Next wrong values, wrong values is equal to 40 and 27. These are the informations given to find. Correct mean, first one, and correct standard deviation. Correct standard deviation. So using the correct values, we have to find the correct mean and correct standard deviation. For that, we have to take the wrong values fully outside. When the values wrong values kuttirukanga adu fulla velila eduthu we include the correct value. Idhukku idhukku difference evlonlam no need to find like that. You take all the wrong values outside and include the correct values. So solution, so first they are giving mean, we take that one. So consider mean comma, x bar is equal to 60. Mean comma, x bar equal to 60. We know the formula for mean, sigma x by n is equal to 60. Sigma x by n we know, it is given as 100. So by 100 is equal to 60. So sigma x equal to 60 into 100. That is equal to 6000. This is incorrect sigma x. Kuduthirukka sigma ku appo appadiye kandupidikku. So take it as incorrect sigma x. Incorrect sigma x equal to 6000. Now we find correct sigma x. So correct value of sigma x is equal to, come to the next line, that is equal to incorrect sigma x minus wrong, we take the wrong values fully outside. So wrong values plus correct values. They give three values, you write that three values. One value. That is equal to 6000 minus the wrong values are 40 and 27. So I write it as 40 plus 27. Two values they are giving. My plus correct value. Correct value is 45 and 72. So 45 plus 72. 45 plus 72. Now simplify this one. That is equal to 6000. 6000 minus 67 plus 170. 117. That is equal to 6000. The difference between these two is 50. So that is equal to 6050. This is the value for the correct sigma x. So correct sigma x equal to 6050. We need correct mean. So correct mean equal to correct mean comma x bar is equal to correct sigma x by n. Correct sigma x by n. That is equal to 6050 by 100. That is 60.50, or you can write it as 60.5. Denominator here having 100, so after two digits you have to keep the decimal point. So the answer is 60.5. This is the value for correct mean. So correct mean is equal to this one. So from the answer. Now we have to find it for correct standard deviation. So next one, consider standard deviation. Standard deviation. The symbol for it is sigma. It is giving us correct deviation sigma, that is given as 50. We come to near, we write near from the margin. That is, I write the formula for sigma. That is sigma x squared by n minus sigma x by n whole square using square root. That is equal to 50. I want to remove the square root, so squaring on both sides. Squaring on both sides. Sigma x square by n minus sigma x by n whole square, that is equal to 15 square. Sigma x square we don't know. So sigma x square by 100 minus sigma x by n. We can write it as x bar. So x bar whole square 225. Sigma x square by 100. This is incorrect sigma x. In the question itself they give incorrect mean is 60. So we have to write it as 60 square is equal to 225. So sigma x square by 100 is equal to 225 plus 3600. Sigma x squared by 1000 is 100 is equal to 3825. Now bring the 100 to the right hand side. So sigma x squared is equal to 3825 into 100. That is 3825 add 2 zeros. This much of value you are getting. This is incorrect, sigma x y. This is incorrect. Therefore, incorrect sigma x squared is equal to write this one 382,500. Now we have to find correct sigma x squared. So correct sigma x squared equal to come to the next line. Incorrect sigma x squared minus square of the wrong values. So wrong values 4 square. Take the wrong values fully outside and the right correct values 4 square. Whole square. That is equal to incorrect sigma x value is right this way. 0500 minus wrong values are 40. So 40 square, another one wrong value 27 whole square plus correct values 45 whole square plus 72 whole square. Wrong values plus square pointing correct wrong values take it outside, correct values include inside the equation. That is equal to 382,500 minus 1600 minus 729 plus 45 whole square, that is 2025 plus 72 whole square, that is 5184. Add all the positive values. The value will be 389,709 minus 2,389,709 minus 2,329. If we subtract it, that is equal to the remaining values 387,380. Inside you can write simply 990, 10, 2, 8. Remaining 6 is 3, so 9 and 2 subtract 9 and 7, remaining 38. So this is the value for correct value of sigma x squared. That is that for correct value of sigma x squared is equal to 387,380. Now you have to find the correct standard deviation. So correct standard deviation is equal to correct standard deviation comma sigma, come to the next line, that is equal to this is correct sigma x squared by n minus correct mean, or you can write it as sigma x by n also within the square root. That is equal to 387,380 by 100 minus correct mean is 60.5. So add that one. Write that value 60.5 whole square within the square root. Now here simplify of last two digits. 3873.80 minus 60.5 whole square. The value is 3660.25. That is equal to, while subtracting, you are getting answer as 213.50. Now you have to find the square root for this one. So 213. One here from the whole numbers you have to take the last two digits, the last two digits you divide it into pair. So 2 you are having, 1 ones are 1, subtracting again 1, write the next two numbers, 1, 2. Now so multiply by 2, 2. So now near 2 you have to write one number, you have to get the value less than 130. If you write 4 times means you are getting the answer as 96. Again subtracting 7, 1, write the next two number. That is 55. Now multiply by 2, 28. Near 28 you have to write one number, it is must be less than 1755. So again write 6 times, point out the number of a point. 6 times means the value is 1716. Subtracting 9, 4 minus 1, 3, 3, 9, add 2, 0. After point we have to write a 2 decimal point. So again multiply. That is 2920. One time only we can write it. So 2921. So the answer will be, that is equal to 14.6. So answer, correct mean is equal to, it is 60.5. Correct standard deviation is equal to 14.6. So we are using the formula alone. 15th sum. The mean and the variance of 7 observations. So totally there are 7 observations. Mean is 8, standard deviation is 60. If 5 of the values are, so out of 7 observations, they give the 5 values. Find the remaining 2 values. So we have to find the remaining 2 observations. So the same procedure. The 14th and the 15th sum, there is no tablet column. But the calculations are manually we have to do. No shortcut method and manually we have to do. So solution. The first we write given. Given. Number of observations is equal to number of observations, comma, n is equal to 7. Next, mean, comma, x bar equal to, it is 8. Standard deviation, comma, sigma is, it is given, not standard deviation, sorry, it is variance, not standard deviation, it is given as variance. So variance is variance, no symbol for variance. So variance is equal to 60. The 5 observations are two, four, ten, two, four, ten, twelve, and fourteen. We have to find the remaining 2 observations. So to find remaining two observations. Manually we have to do this one. So we find solution. So we take the remaining 2 observations as A and B. Let the remaining 2 observations are remaining 2 observations are A and B. Remaining two observations are A and B. So for one value we take it as A, another value we take it as B. Mean comma x bar equal to, we are giving us 8. So that is sigma, I will write the value for this one. Sigma x by n is equal to 8. Sigma x means we have to add all the values, that is 2 plus 4 plus 10 plus 12 plus 14. We take the remaining as A and B. So write this one. Whole divided by number of observation is 7. That is equal to 8. If you add these two numbers, they are getting 42 plus A plus B by 7 is equal to 8. Cross multiplying, 42 plus A plus B is equal to 7, 8 are 56. Now bring this 42 to that side. Right answer. A plus B equal to 56 minus 42, that is equal to 40. A plus B is equal to 40. A plus B is equal to 40. Take this one as first equation. So from the mean we are getting one equation. We are coming to the standard variance. Consider variance is equal to 60. It is given in the question. So the formula for variance, square root, the standard deviation formula without square root. So sigma x squared by n minus sigma x by n whole square is equal to 60. For finding this value, we draw the tablet card. Inside we can draw. So xi value. Xi, next you write it as xi square. Xi values are, it is given as 2, 4, 10, 12, 14, A, B. For A square, for xi square, you have to square this value. So we draw it in the tablet column. We can draw in the tablet column this side. Here we can draw this one. So take it as 2. You take this one as second equation. We find the value for this one. So xi. You can take it as xi or x. So xi. Here xi square. Xi value 2, 4, 10, 12. 14, 5 values we are getting, remaining 2 values we take it as AB. Xi squared. Okay, students. Here we can draw the tabroid color. So xi 2, 4, 10, 12, 14, a, b. Xi squared. You have to square this one. 4, 16, 100, 144, 196, a squared. This is b squared. We have to find the sum, sigma xi. So sigma xi is equal to, we are getting 42 plus a plus b. Whereas sigma xi squared is equal to, if you add these two numbers, you are getting 460 plus a squared plus b squared. 460 plus a square plus b square. Now substitute the values here. That is equal to 460 plus a square plus b square by n value. It is 7. Instead of sigma x by x and by n, we can write it as x bar square equal to 16. In the question itself, they are giving the mean as 8. So, a square plus b square by 7. Instead of this x bar, you write it as 8 square equal to 16. Now, simplify. 460 plus a square plus b square by 7 is equal to 16 plus 64. Bring that 8 square to the right hand side. So, 460 plus a square plus b square is by 7 is equal to, while you are adding, you are getting the answer as it is 80. Bring this 7 to next side. The 460 plus a square plus b square is equal to 80 into 7. That is 560. So a square plus b square is equal to, bring that minus 460 to the right hand side. So the answer will be 100. So a square plus b square value is 100. We know in algebra, we studied a square plus b square value. We know that a square plus b square can be written as a plus b whole square minus 2ab. The same procedure here apply. This can be written as a plus b whole square minus 2ab is equal to 100. In the first equation, we are getting a plus b is 14. So, we can write it as 14 square minus 2ab is equal to 100 by 1. By the first equation, we are getting this value. So, minus 2ab is equal to 100. 14 square, it is 196. When it comes to the right hand side, it becomes minus 196. So, minus 2ab is equal to minus 96. Cancel minus sign on both sides. This can be written as 2ab is equal to, ab is equal to 96 by 2. So ab equal to 48. So from that I take b equal to. So b equal to 48 by a. So we are getting one relation between a and b. So using what? Substitute b equal to 48 by a in first equation. First equation, a plus b is equal to 48. So instead of b, substitute this one. A plus 48 by a is equal to 40. Take a as LCM. A square plus 48 is equal to, whole divided by a equal to 40. Bring it to the right hand side, denominator. A square plus 48 equal to 40. Correct. Bring all the terms to the left hand side. A square minus 14a plus 48 equal to 0. The product is plus 48. The sum is minus 40. 6 8s are 48. Add pending enough, you are getting 14. So minus. It is in the coefficient of a squared is 1. So we can write the answer directly. A minus 6 into a minus 8 equal to 0. Product of the two terms is 0 means implies either of the terms equal to 0. So either a minus b equal to a minus 6 equal to 0 or a minus 8 equal to a minus 8 equal to 0. So we are getting a equal to 6 or a equal to 8. If a equal to 6, we have b is equal to 48 by a. So b equal to 48 by 6, b equal to 8. This is one value. If a equal to 8, b is equal to 48 by 8, that is 48 by 8, that is 6. B equal to 6. So a is either a 6 or 8. The b value is also 8 or 6. So answer, the remaining two observations are, remaining two observations are, six and eight are 8 and 6. 6 and 8 are 8 and 6. Okay, example 8.10. Find the mean and variance of the first n natural numbers. We use the result of this one in 6th, 7th sum. So, I will explain. Find the mean and the variance of the first n natural numbers. For that, we know the mean is equal to the solution. Mean comma x bar. Usually we take it as sigma x by n. Here sum of the numbers is 1, 2, 3 up to n natural numbers. So we can write it as 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4 plus etc. up to n natural numbers whole divided by n. Natural numbers only they are giving, that is why I take it from 1. The algebra you already studied about special series. Not in algebra, sequence and series. Last one, special series in Bachelpenya, last exercise. So 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4 plus etc. up to n. This can be written as sigma xi, or you can write the answer directly. N into n plus 1 by 2. Already have one n, so this can be written as n. So cancel this n and n. So the answer will be n plus 1 by 2. So, mean of the first n natural number is n plus 1 by 2. Therefore, mean comma x bar is this one. Next one, you have to find the standard variance. First, the mean and variance only they are giving. So, variance we have to find. So, variance, we know it is standard deviation whole square. So, variance comma sigma square is equal to, I write it in the next line, sigma x n xi, you can write it as I by n whole square minus sigma x by n whole square sigma xi square. Next only you have to write it as whole square sigma xi square by n minus sigma x by n whole square. That is the meaning for this one is 1 square, 2 square plus 3 square plus etc. up to n square whole divided by n minus sigma xi by n. This value you can write in the same procedure, the mean. Instead of this one, you can write the value for mean itself. That is n plus 1, or in the from the book it is not given like this. so they write. So I can write 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus etc. up to n. 4 divided by n. Now simplify this one. That is equal to 1 square 2 square. That is square of the first n natural number. So this can be written. The formula for this one is n into n plus 1 into 2n plus 1 by 6. In the denominator you already have n, so write that n. Minus this one is n enumerated, n into n plus 1 by 2 denominator into n. This can be written as n get cancelled, the remaining term will be n plus 1 2n plus 1 by 6 minus n plus 1 whole squared by 2 by 2. For 6 and 2 we have to find LCM. You know it is 12. 2 table putting in a 3 1 sorry n into n plus 1 by whole square, that is 2 square. This value is equal to 4. Again you can write it as 2 table. This can be written as n plus 1 2n plus 1 by 6 minus n plus 1 whole square by 4. The LCM is 12. LCM equal to 12. So take LCM as 12. This can be written as n into 2 into n plus 1 2n plus 1 minus 3 into n plus 1 whole square. Now you have to simplify the numerator. That is take 2. Multiply this one. Or you can write it. Multiply by 2n square plus n plus 2n plus 1 whole divided by 2 to minus 3 into n plus 1 whole square, n square plus 2n plus 1 whole divided by 2. Now bring 2 inside, 2 into 2n square plus 3n plus 1 minus 3 into n square plus 2n plus 1 whole divided by 12. That is equal to, bring 2 inside, 4n square plus 6n plus 2 minus 3n square minus 6n minus 3 whole divided by 12. So 4n square minus n square, the value is n square plus 6n minus 1. So, minus 1 whole divided by 4. Therefore, variance is equal to n square minus 1 divided by 4. This is the derivation given in the book. You can see the steps. Thank you, students.